Avalanche by Mark Foster and Philip Burroughs, Oxford University Press.
Mom, Buster is eating the sausages,
says Maxine. Mrs. Baxter takes the sausages from Buster. She is angry.
He's a very bad dog, she says.
He can't come to Scotland with us.
Buster is Ben's dog. Ben isn't happy because Buster is not going to the mountains with them.
Please, Mom, can he come?
Ben says.
No, take him to the kennels now,
says Ben's mom.
I'm sorry, Buster,
says Ben. They begin to walk to the kennels. Ben's family put their bags into the van. Ben comes back from the kennels. Everybody is waiting for him. Ben gets in the van. He's carrying his bag carefully.
What's in your bag?
Asks Maxime.
Nothing,
says Ben. They drive to Scotland. Ben and Maxime are very happy. They are going skiing. All the Baxter family can ski. They go to the mountains every year. They drive for an hour. Then Mr. Baxter hears a strange noise.
Who's making that noise?
He asks.
Not me,
says Ben quickly. Then they hear the noise again.
I can hear it too,
says Maxine.
It's coming from your bag, Ben.
Mr. Baxter stops the car.
What's in your bag, Ben?
He asks. Woof, says Buster. Mr. Baxter is very angry.
We're nearly at the mountains now. Buster can come with us, but he must stay with you, Ben.
Ben is happy. Buster wags his tail. Later they arrive at the skiing village. A girl tells them,
your house has got a green door and blue windows.
The next day the weather is good. Ben and his family are very happy because they are going skiing. Ben looks out of the window and sees the mountain.
The mountains are beautiful,
Ben thinks.
But they can be dangerous too.
The family put on their skiing clothes and go out. Buster must stay in the house, but he does not want to go out. He wants to stay in the warm house. Soon the Baxters are on the ski lift. They go up the mountain. They look down.
Look at the beautiful little houses,
says Maxine.
There's our house,
says Ben.
Let's ski down there. Come on.
Ben and Maxine can ski well. They go down the mountain very fast.
Be careful,
calls Ben's mom. She and Mr. Baxter go after them slowly. Mr. and Mrs. Baxter cannot see the children.
Where are they?
Says Mrs. Baxter.
I don't know,
Mr. Baxter answers. He skis quickly away from his wife.
Where are you going?
Says Mrs. Baxter.
I want to find Ben and Maxine.
There are a lot of people on the mountain. Mr. Baxter cannot see Ben and Maxine.
Where are they?
He thinks. He sees some people far away.
Is that Ben and Maxine?
He thinks and begins to ski to them. He skis fast and often falls in the snow. Soon he cannot see Mrs. Baxter, he cannot see the village, he cannot see any people now. Mr. Baxter is afraid, he thinks.
Are Ben and Maxine on this mountain?
He calls.
Ben! Maxine! Can you hear me?
Nobody answers. Mr. Baxter feels cold. He skis down the mountain. He skis faster and faster. Suddenly, he stops and looks up and down the mountain.
Where am I?
He thinks.
I'm lost.
2 hours later, Mrs. Baxter is waiting in the house with the children.
That's very late, Mom,
says Ben.
Is he okay?
Yes, he's okay,
says Mrs. Baxter, but she looks at the clock and thinks.
Where is he? Perhaps he is lost.
Maxine looks out of the window. She can see a lot of people. Some of the people are policemen.
Mom, who are those people?
She asks. Mrs. Baxter looks out of the window too.
Oh no!
She says and runs to the door.
What's happening?
She asks.
It's an avalanche,
says a policeman.
Are there some people under the snow?
Asks Mrs. Baxter.
Yes, perhaps,
says the policeman.
We must go and look. My husband,
says Mrs. Baxter. Buster runs out of the door.
Buster, come here,
calls Ben. He cannot see Buster because there are a lot of people.
Buster,
he calls again. In the house, Mrs. Baxter talks to the policeman.
My husband isn't here,
she says.
He's on the mountain. Perhaps he's in the avalanche.
It's a small avalanche and it's far away,
says the policeman.
Perhaps he isn't on the mountain. Perhaps he's in the village.
No,
says Mrs. Baxter.
He's on the mountain. You must find him.
Ben is afraid.
Where's Dad?
He thinks.
And where's Buster?
He says to the policeman.
My dog isn't here. He's small and brown and is called Buster. Perhaps he's in the village. Can you find him too?
The policeman smiles.
Yes,
he says. But Buster is not in the village. Buster is on the mountain. He is looking for Mr. Baxter. The snow on the mountain is very deep, and Buster often falls. He is very tired, but he does not stop. He wants to find Mr. Baxter. Buster sees Mr. Baxter's hat. Then he sees his keys. They are in the snow, but Buster cannot see Mr. Baxter. There is deep snow everywhere. Buster digs in the snow. It is difficult, but Buster digs very fast. Suddenly, Buster hears a noise. He stops digging and listens. Somebody is saying,
Help!
It's Mr. Baxter. Buster can hear him, but where is he? Buster hears Mr. Baxter again.
Help!
He says very quietly. Some snow moves near a big rock. Buster runs to the rock and begins to dig. Is Mr. Baxter here? Buster digs quickly. Suddenly, he sees a shoe. Then he sees a leg. Then Mr. Baxter's arms come out of the snow. After 10 minutes, Mr. Baxter is free. Buster is very happy. He runs up and down and wags his tail. Mr. Baxter is happy too, but he is healed.
My leg,
he says.
Somebody must help me. Buster, find Ben. Go quickly.
In the house, Mrs. Baxter, Ben, and Maxime are waiting. Through the window, they see the helicopter.
Can the helicopter find Dad?
Asks Maxime.
Yes, it can,
says Mrs. Baxter, but she is afraid.
He's under the snow, she thinks, and the helicopter can't see him.
Suddenly, they hear a noise. Ben looks at the door.
It's Buster,
he says. He runs to the door and opens it. He sees Buster. Buster is tired and dirty.
Come in,
says Ben. But Buster does not come in. He walks away, then looks at Ben and barks. He walks away and barks again.
Mom, Buster is telling us something,
says Ben.
What is it, Buster? Is it Dad?
Buster wags his tail. He runs to Ben and barks again.
Buster is saying come with me,
says Ben.
Come on.
On the road, there are some policemen. They are beginning to walk up the mountain.
Come with us, says Ben. My father is up here.
Buster runs in front of them.
Buster, wait for us,
calls Ben. An hour later, the policemen find Mr. Baxter. A doctor looks at his leg.
We must take you to the hospital,
the doctor says. The policemen put Mr. Baxter on a stretcher. Buster gets on the stretcher too.
Get off, Buster,
says Mrs. Baxter.
No,
says Mr. Baxter.
Buster is tired. He can stay with me.
Mr. Baxter puts his arm around Buster.
Thank you, Buster. You can go skiing with us every year.